ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக சில்ட்ரன், வெல்கம் டு அவர் ஆன்லைன் டீச்சிங் அகாடமி ஏக்கலைவா. டுடே ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் இன் மிஸ்லேனியஸ் எக்ஸசைஸ் क्वेश्चन नंबर 29, दैट इज इंटीग्रल 0 टू 1 1 डिवाइडेड बाय स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 1 माइनस एक्स माइनस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ एक्स इनटू डीएक्स. सी हियर द गिवन इंटीग्रेंड वी कैन नॉट इंटीग्रेट डायरेक्टली, सो we are going to do the rationalize the integrand, right? Rationalize the integrand. Or you can apply the property also, right? Integral 0 to 1, better you can use rationalize the denominator. Rationalize the integrand. I equal to integral 0 to 1, 1 divided by, rationalize the integrand means you want to take a conjugate. Here negative is there, so you have to use positive and multiply both numerator and denominator. 1 minus x plus x divided by square root of 1 minus x the whole square minus root x the whole square. Rationalize the denominator means you want to take a conjugate and multiply both numerator and denominator. That is the meaning, right? Now integral 0 to 1 square root of 1 minus x plus root x. Here you cannot apply the property, children. You want to do the rationalize the denominator only. Now, root of 1 minus x square means that can be written as 1. Yeah, sorry, question itself wrong. 1 plus x, 1 plus x, 1 plus x, 1 plus x. So, 1 plus x minus x into dx. Plus x minus x cancel. Question is root of 1 plus x. Now I equal to integral 0 to 1. You are going to write it as a sum of two integrals. 1 plus x into dx plus integral 0 to 1 root x into dx. Right? Now, integral x power n dx equal to the formula x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Here what can you get? Integral 0 to 1, 1 plus x the whole power 1 by 2 into dx plus integral 0 to 1 x power 1 by 2 into dx, then it can be written as 2 by 3 into 1 plus x the whole power 3 by 2 plus 2 by 3 into x power 3 by 2 limit 0 to 1. Now 2 by 3 is common, you have to take it outside. 2 by 3, you should take it outside. Then 1 plus x the whole power 3 by 2 plus x power 3 by 2, 0 to 1, which is equal to 2 by 3, upper limit 1 plus 1, 2, 2 to the power 3 by 2 plus 1 power 3 by 2 upper limit minus lower limit. Minus lower limit. Lower limit in the first bracket 1 power 3 by 2 plus 0 power 3 by 2. Now it is equal to 2 by 3 into root 2 the whole power 3 plus 1 minus 1. What it 1 raised to anything, the value it becomes 1 only. 1 raised to anything, it becomes 1. So 1, 1 cancel. Plus 1 minus 1 cancel. Then I equal to 2 into 2 root 2 divided by 3. Here root 2 into root 2 into root 2. So it can be written as 4 root 2 divided by 3. Got it, children? Now I am going to move to question number 27. Question number 27. Integral 0 to pi by 2 cos square x divided by 4 minus, sorry, divided by cos square x divided by cos square x plus 4 sin square x dx. Right? Now, I am going to use the identity sin square x equal to 1 minus cos square x. Using this, I am going to replace sin square in terms of cos square. I equal to first step. The given integrand, we cannot integrate directly. We have to think how to solve. Right? Cos square x plus 4 into 1 minus cos square x into dx, which is equal to integral cos square x divided by cos square x plus 4 minus 4 cos square x dx. Right? Next. I equal to, you have to listen carefully, children. Cos square x divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x into dx. Now also I cannot integrate. So based on the denominator, I am going to do the modification in the numerator. First step, what I am going to do, you have to listen. I am going to multiply and divide by minus 3. Multiply and divide by minus 3. That means minus 1 by 3 integral minus 3 cos square x divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x into dx. Multiply and divide. Now, see here 4 is there. Based on this, I am going to add 4 and subtract 4. Minus 1 by 3 integral 0 to pi by 2. That limit you don't forget to write, children. 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2, 4 minus 3 cos square x plus 4 divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x. I didn't disturb the given function. At the same time, our convenient, I modified. right? Rather convenient, I modify the function. Now I am going to write it in terms of to separate. How I am going to write, you see, which is equal to minus 1 by 3 into integral 4 minus 3 cos square x divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x dx minus 1 by 3 into integral 4 divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x into dx, right? Minus 1 by 0 to pi by 2. 0 to pi by 2. Got it? This is my I1. This is my I2. First, I1, that is easy to integrate because these two things are cancelled. Minus 1 by 3 into integral dx 0 to pi by 2, which is equal to minus 1 by 3 into x 0 to pi by 2, which is equal to minus pi by 6 I2. I2 equal to integral 0 to pi by 2, integral 0 to pi by 2, 1 divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. The 4 you have to take it out, right? Then the cos square, I am going to write it as 1 by secant square. Cos square, I am going to write it as 1 by secant square. One minute, children. Minus 4. Instead of minus 4, I put plus 4. Sorry. So here you have to write it as minus 4, then it becomes plus, right? 4 by 3. The I2 integral is 4 by 3. I added 4, subtracted 4. Now, integral 0 to pi by 2, 1 divided by 4 minus 3, 1 by secant square x dx. Cos square, I write it in terms of secant, right? Now I am going to take LCM. Integral 0 to pi by 2 secant square x divided by 4 into secant square x minus 3 into dx. Into dx. Now secant square, I am going to use the identity. 1 plus tan square x equal to secant square x. 1 plus tan square equal to secant square x. Here I am going to adapt substitution. T is equal to tan x. Dt equal to the denominator, right? See here, I2 equal to integral 0 to pi by 2 secant square x divided by 4 into 1 plus tan square x minus 3. The differentiation of tan, it will give you the secant square x dx. So dt, that you are going to consider as a variable. Dt equal to secant square x dx. The numerator, it represents the differentiation of your denominator. So that you are going to consider as a variable t. I 2 equal to, once if you adapt substitution, the limit also change, I said, right? So integral 0 to pi by 2, how it should be? 0 to infinity. When x is equal to 0, t equal to 0, x is equal to pi by 2, t is equal to infinity. So integral 0 to infinity, secant square x dx can be replaced by dt, divided by 4 into 1 plus t square minus 3. 4 into 1 plus t square minus 3. Now, integral 0 to infinity dt divided by 4 t square plus 1. 4 t square plus 1. Got it, children? Now, it comes under your what? Standard form. Here, I am going to take 1 by 4 as common in the denominator. Integral 0 to infinity dt divided by t square, right? 4 you have to take it as a common. So t square plus 1 by 4, which is equal to 1 by 4 into integral 0 to infinity dt divided by t square plus 1 by 2 the whole square. Now it looks like your standard format, that is dx divided by x square plus a square. Integral dx divided by x square plus a square is nothing but 1 by a into tan inverse x by a plus c. The denominator I took 4 as common, right? Now I 2 equal to 1 by a, that is 2, 1 by 1 by 2, that I wrote it as 2, tan inverse, what, 2t, tan inverse 2t, 1 by 4 already it is there, so into 1 by 4, 2 cancel, then tan inverse 2t, limit 0 to infinity, which is equal to 1 by 2 into tan inverse 2 into infinity minus tan inverse 0, which is equal to 1 by 2 into tan infinity is pi by 2, pi by 2, which is equal to pi by 4, which is equal to pi by 4. What it? Tan inverse 0 is 0. So I didn't write that. Right, children? Now, what is my I2? 4 by 3, right? I2 equal to 4 by 3 into 1 pi by 4. 4, 4 cancel. You will get it as pi by 3. Now, I equal to I1 plus I2. I equal to I1 plus I2. My I1 is minus pi by 6. I2 is pi by 3. Take LCM, minus pi plus 2 pi, which is equal to pi by 6. Right? Therefore, I equal to pi by 6. Once again, I am going to explain the question number 27. You have to listen carefully, children. What are the process I did? At the same time, I am very conscious I didn't disturb the given function. Right? Integral 0 to pi by 2. Cos square x divided by cos square x plus 4 sin square x. Then sin square I replace in terms of cos square, 1 minus cos square. Then denominator I arrived 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. Based on the denominator, I am going to do the modification in the numerator. For that purpose, I multiply and divide by minus 3. So minus 3 cos square x minus 1 by 3. Minus 3 cos square x by 4 minus 3 cos square x. I cannot integrate. For that purpose, I added 4 and subtract 4. The same denominator concept I used in the numerator. Now, then 4 minus, already 1 minus 1 by 3 is there, that is common for both the terms. 4 by 3 cos square x by 4 by 4 minus 3 cos square x. 4 minus 3 cos square x by 4 minus 3 cos square x. Minus into minus plus 1 by 3. 4 by 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. First one I consider as I1. Second one I consider as I2. Now my I1 minus 1 by 3 into integral 0 to pi by 2 dx. When I integrate dx, I got x. Then I apply the upper limit and the lower limit. I arrive at the result as minus pi by 6. If you want, you have to apply like this. Upper limit minus lower limit, which is equal to minus pi by 6. Here, I2, 0 to pi by 2, the 4 by 3, you have to keep it in your mind. I took only the integrand part. 0 to pi by 2, 1 minus 4, 1 divided by 4 minus 3 cos square x dx. Now, the cos square I written in terms of secant. That is 3 into 1 by secant square. 1 by secant square is nothing but cos square. Then I took LCM. Secant square x by 4 secant square x minus 3 into dx. The secant square x I replaced in terms of tan. 4 into 1 plus tan square x minus 3. If I select tan x as t, I arrived the result of the numerator what it exists here. That is when I did the differentiation. Dt equal to secant square x dx. So secant square x dx can be replaced by dt. Here 4 into 1 plus t square minus 3. Now when I add up substitution, I told you to change the limit also. The limit is 0 to infinity. Here 4t square plus 1. Somehow I arrived the standard format. Now again I am going to do the modification, simplification, right? 4 I took it as a common. Then I wrote t square plus 1 by 4. 1 by 4 you should take it out. The 1 by 4 I write it in terms of 1 by 2 the whole square. It is our standard format as dx divided by integral dx divided by x square plus a square, that is 1 by a into tan inverse x by a. So 2 into 1 by 4, right? Because 1 by a, here your a is 1 by 2, that I wrote it as a reciprocal to already 1 by 4 is there. So 2 into 1 by 4 tan inverse 2t 0 to infinity. 1 by 2 tan inverse 2 times infinity minus tan inverse 0. Tan infinity is nothing but pi by 2. Tan 0 is 0. So 1 by 2 into pi by 2 equal to pi by 4. My I2 is 4 by 3 into pi by 4. So pi by 3. Finally, I add I equal to I1 plus I2. I1 is minus pi by 6. I3 I arrived as pi by 3. Finally, we reach the result as pi by 6. Thank you, children.